Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, I'll show you how to do effects like this, changing one object to another. And I'll show you how to do this inside of DaVinci Resolve 17. If you are new to this channel and want to learn DaVinci Resolve filmmaking tips and tricks and want to have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. If you want to support the channel even more, push the join button down below and become a member. Also, please do join our Facebook group because I want to make a great community over there as well. Well, with that out of the way, let's get right to the video. Okay, so let's get right to this little tutorial. So here we have the two clips. And as you see, this is just a super rough cut. So we'll just jump right to the next can. First thing I want to do is to highlight my clips, and I want to take out these black bars, and I'll do that out in the inspector, and I'll go under the video and I'll go down to retime and scaling, and I'm going to put this into fill. So now we just cut out those black bars. So this is the morph effect. It's actually super easy to do. All you have to do is to go up to the effects library, go into the video transitions, and here we have smooth cut. And what smooth cut is, it's determining, or it's actually adding in frames. So this is actually a super nice transition if you are having jump cuts and stuff like that. But we are now going to make a morph effect using that. So I'm just going to put that right on here. And, you know, it works out pretty well. We can change the look of it by making this smaller. And of course, we can have a look here. If we want it to be like a long transition, we'll just drag this longer like that. But in this case, I want it to be shorter. So something like that, something like that. And then, you know, if we then highlight the transitions, we can go up here in the transitions panel here in the inspector. And we have, of course, now we can see that this is the smooth cut, the duration. And we can also go in here where we have the modes, and we can change that to better or faster. We can see if we can see a difference, actually. Here we have faster, and here we have better. I'll leave it at better. And then also we can add in the ease in effects here. So I'm just going to put this on in. And now we have this effect here. Something like that. Okay. Maybe I'll just make it a little longer. So there we have the effect. So one thing we can do, because obviously we want to do some grading, and maybe we also want to do a couple of other things. So first up, what you can do to grade this clip super fast or easy is actually to, again, go to the effects library, go into effects, and now we have a adjustment clip. And I'm going to drag down the adjustment clip on top of this clip here, and I'm going to select that, and I'll go directly into the color tab. And here I have my adjustment clip. If you have a lot of clips, it can be pretty hard to figure out which clip is what, actually. In that case, you can use the timeline, and you are going to have a timeline view of your thing, which is right here. But for this, I'm not going to. So I'll just go into the colors here, and I think just going to go into the gain. I'm going to lift up the light a bit, and then I'll play around with the gamma here, making it a little bit darker. And then I have my lift where I can cross the blacks, or I can lift the colors. In this case, I'm going to actually cross the colors just a little bit. And then I can add in some contrast. I can play around with the tint if I want to, and then the temperature to make it more cold or warm. So I think something like that. And because I'm doing this on the adjustment clip, I don't need to do this individual on the clips. And this can be very helpful if you are having projects with a lot of clips. You can actually do it that way and simply just do all the grading in the adjustment clip. So last thing to do is I want to add in some movements. And again, Of course, I could go into the individual clips and zoom, or I could make a compound clip and make a zoom on that. But for this thing, I'm just going to use the adjustment clip, and I'm simply just going to add in a dynamic zoom. So that's what I've done here, and this is the final effect. So of course you can use this effect for product reviews and stuff like that, or commercials where you want to do some kind of a morph transition. A very good thing to keep in mind is that try to keep the object at the same spot, so the morphing effect would actually be better. Also keep the objects around the same size to make the transformation better. Okay, anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.